Hey guys, this is another episode in the Jumper series. Now if you've been watching my videos, you're probably wondering how this account has 1.1 billion food, 1.1 billion lumber as a level 5. That's what we're going to go over today. This is a little bit more advanced, so if you aren't pretty serious about your jumper, you're probably not going to want to put the time into this, but I'm going to explain how I did it. So if we look at my resources tab here, we see produced almost 3 billion total resources. The amount you're going to produce in town is pretty much nothing. You're going to be capped out immediately on your jumper. This is what the typical jumper will look a little bit more like. So that'd be about 640 million total resources split across 5 resource fields. It's a decent bit, but the real kicker is right here, pillaged from other towns. I wouldn't really advise going after your standard towns. You can get a decent bit of resources from that, but it can be expensive in gold. You risk getting hit and losing your troops, which you need for KVKs. What I did was I made an alt. Actually two alts. So you make two alts, you have them transfer resources to each other, and then you attack them. If we come over and look at my military tab, total attacks 2,886. That's a lot of attacks. Remember, you can only send one march at a time with a total of 11,000 troops, 10 if you don't have a high VIP level. So this is another reason to try to max out your capacity. With 11,000 siege units, I get about 450,000 resources per hit, which doesn't seem like a ton, but if you're looking at about a 15-second round trip per attack for almost 500,000 resources compared to how long that would take you to either produce in your town or to go out and yield, it's incredibly fast. Can make that a little bit better by using march size increases or marching speed buffs. I wouldn't really advise using the speed buffs just because those are so valuable later on. But the march size increases are probably worth it, especially if you get one of the 12-hour ones. Another thing I would highly advise doing is getting the program auto-it. There's a video on my channel going over how to set that up to automatically complete your tasks. You can adjust that so that it does these attacks for you. Just looking at the stats here, I think it was about 15 seconds per march. So if we look at 15 times 2.8, we're going to do 2850, because I had 35, 36 attacks before doing this. So 15 seconds for a round trip. Divided by 60 seconds. So 712 hours this would have taken. Now I did use some marching speed ups and some march size increases, so it was a little bit quicker, but it's not really something you want to do manually. Yeah, so get auto it. So what I did was I made two accounts, both to 21. Kind of played around with this one recently, that's why it's 22. One of them silver and another resource, and the other one is just purely this resource because you won't be able to produce silver in both locations. And so this one sends silver and stone to the other one sends iron back here. Now if we take a quick look at the stats here, 2.4 and 1.5 million an hour, it's not bad, it's not great. I'm just using the 50% buffs, so there'd be a decent bit more if I was really building up right now. I've gotten to the point where I have too much resources, so I'm never gonna be able to transfer it all. So I've kind of just been sending it all to the stronghold, which is another way to kind of keep your clan happy. You may not be able to produce much on your jumper, but if you're sending all of your resources to the stronghold, they're going to love you. Since I'm not really upgrading anything here, I can do that pretty easily. A couple of other nice little perks of having support accounts for your jumper. You can use the hero on your support account to knock down level 1 invaders so that your jumper can just instantly kill them. You get a lot more materials that way. Another thing I like to use my gold to buy clan refreshers, and then once I use the clan refreshers, I can buy scrolls. Now you can't typically transfer scrolls. Let's see if I can find where that is. Maybe under resources. Yes, yeah, so this has 2,000 scrolls. You can't typically transfer these, but if your jumper and your alt both leaves clan and they start their own clan, you can send the scrolls to the head of the clan. So you can transfer all of these to your main jumper. I think I have like 3,000 to 4,000 on my main jumper, and then 2,000 here, and some more on my other support account. As far as I've been able to figure out, this is the best way to make sure the gold from your support accounts is transferred in some way to benefit your jumper account. More resources would be great, but really, unless you're doing this 24/7, your jumper isn't going to be able to keep up with the resource production on your two support accounts anyways. So this is another good option. Another option to building up resources for your jumper is to make a new jumper, get it to Palace 5, and then just let it sit. Once it's got mega packs after the first 3 to 4 weeks, start watching out for holiday deals. Your offers on a jumper are going to be greatly reduced outside of these holiday deals. Typically, they will be somewhat reduced, but it's still going to be a ridiculously good offer. So for this one, I don't plan on spending any money, so it's okay that it's got another 8 weeks before I get mega packs again. But what I did get was between 1.5 and 1.6 billion silver. That pretty much sets my jumper up for silver for quite a while, and it was $5 or $10. That means when I jump, I'm pretty much set for silver. Now this account, I do plan on actually using as a resource production account on the new server, but you don't have to. You could just bring it over, transfer all of the stuff, and dump it, which means it's almost no effort to set this up. It just costs a couple dollars. And we're just doing all of this so that when you jump to your new server, you aren't constrained by the resources you have. Blowing through a couple of years worth of boost that you've built up is gonna be pretty expensive. So yeah, that's pretty much it. If you found this video helpful or interesting, please hit that like or subscribe button. And if you have any questions, leave a comment down below. And I will see you guys soon. Thanks.